We're at Mass General Hospital to do a xenotransplant, a pig kidney transplant, because I am at end-stage renal failure and have been for a couple of years.
There's a huge organ shortage. There's more than 100,000 patients on the waiting list, and we only do about 25,000 transplants a year. Majority of our patients actually have to wait many years to get to the top of the list. During those years, most patients become sicker or they die waiting for that promised kidney transplant. At Mass General Brigham, we've been doing xenotransplant research for now over 30 years. In 1954, at the Peter Bank Brigham, we performed the first human kidney transplant that was successful. In 2024, we performed the first successful xenotransplant. With the technology of CRISPR-Cas, we're able to precisely modify certain genes. There are more than 69 genomic edits, 69 changes in the DNA to make these kidneys more compatible and with a lower risk of infection.
Well, immediately after the first transplant, I wanted to be in this. You can see the light at the end of the tunnel. You know, all of a sudden, I'm not in the darkness. I am going to do this. I had a conversation with Dr. Riella, and I told him, I'm 100% in. I will do anything for you. You tell me what I have to do, and I will do it.
Our entire surgical team went to a facility about an hour from Boston in order to retrieve both kidneys and bring it back to Mass General. The transplant surgery itself is very similar to a traditional human kidney transplant. We can see success very quickly as urine starts getting produced by the transplanted kidney.
Woo-hoo!
There you go.
Nice.
Tim was very confident. He knew that, you know, this is what he wanted to do. For him, it was even beyond something that he was just doing for himself, but really something that he felt was potentially advancing and providing hope for many patients that are currently on dialysis and don't have an organ available for transplantation. When things work out as planned, it's such a joy, and we couldn't have hoped for a better outcome.
My message to those that are on there, don't give up. Fight back. Do everything you can to get ready for the opportunity. I believe this is a start of something that's gonna be fantastic. It's gonna be the option for people that don't wanna be on dialysis, that wanna be able to be with their kids and their loved ones.
Oh, it's nice.
Air.
Fresh air, I love it.
This is their chance. Be hopeful, don't give up.